vogliamo sfide in casa, un robot zero waste.
Now we will hear from sfide in casa, zero waste, we will hear.
Volete, colleghi?
Ciao.
Vediamo se non si sbuglia il periodo.
Ecco qui, look at lots of translations.
Но тъй като каузата е обща, предполагам, ще е интересно да чуете нашата добра практика.
I hope it will be interesting to hear our practices.
И най-вече очаквам да установим много добри контакти и да се помагаме в тази обща кауза.
And I hope that we can establish good contacts and help each other in this common cause.
Община Свиленград.
Муниципалитет Свиленград.
Се намира в югоизточната част на България.
It is located in the southeast part of Bulgaria.
Има жители 24 000 жители.
24,000 inhabitants.
И територия 705 квадратни километра.
And the area is 705 square kilometers.
Намираме се на границата с Турция и Гърция.
We are located on the border between Bulgaria and Turkey and Greece.
Община Свиленград е първата българска община, която е член на Европейската мрежа за нулеви отпадъци.
Свиленград е първата българска община, която е член на Европейската мрежа за нулеви отпадъци.
През 2018 година всъщност станахме кандидатствахме да бъдем член на тази мрежа.
The process started back in 2018 when we applied to become member.
И през 2019 година юни месец бяхме вече на картата на мрежата за нулеви отпадъци, Европейската мрежа.
And in June this year we were officially already, you can find us on the map of Zero Waste Cities that is maintained by Zero Waste.
В тази мрежа членуват много европейски общини, които вече са напреднали или са в началото на тази нелека задача да направят отпадъците нулеви.
This network in West Europe puts together a lot of municipalities, as you may know, and some of them are very advanced, they are zero waste champions, while others are still starting to walk the zero waste path and to implement this quite difficult task of reducing waste.
Подпомагащ орган на общинското ръководство е консултативният съвет за нулеви отпадъци.
To help us in this task, we have established the Zero Waste Advisory Council.
В този консултативен съвет влизат граждани, активни граждани, представители на неправителствени организации, общински съветници, представители на училища.
This council has quite a varied membership. It includes active citizens, non-governmental organizations, local councillors, people from the municipal administration and business representatives.
На този слайд виждате коя беше първата стъпка, след като започнахме да, така да се каже, да се борим с намаляване на отпадъците.
On this photo you can see the first step that we took once we started the walking the road of reducing waste.
Успяхме да сложим 1000 жълти кофи във всяко едно домакинство.
We managed to equip 1000 households with their own personal bins.
като в тези жълти кофи всяко домакинство изхвърля хартия, пластмаса и метални
пенчета. These yellow bins are for segregating packaging waste, so metal, plastics and paper.
Проекта се нарича От врата до врата.
So this is a project called Door to Door Collection.
Тоест, улесняваме гражданите да правят разделно събиране в самото домакинство.
Which is aims to make it far easier for citizens to separate the waste still at source in their household.
Резултатът беше много добър и много бърз. Много бързо успяхме да намалим битовия отпадък в тези домакинства за сметка на разделно събрание отпадък.
The results were very good and very quick. So very quickly we saw a change from mixed waste produced by these households that was reduced a lot and increased in the segregated collected waste.
И постигнахме едно много важно нещо, да не бъде отпадъка анонимен.
And we achieved something else that is very important. The waste is not anonymous anymore. We know who generates it.
Ние сме малка община и града е сравнително малък, хората се познават и по този начин фамилиите станаха по-отговорни към разделно събиране на отпадъци.
So we are a small municipality, people know each other and this makes it easier to have a public pressure so that people can observe the rules and separate their waste properly.
През 2017 година община Свиленград успя да спечели проект от една от оползотворяващите компании Екопак. Проект, с който спечелихме 5000 евро и успяхме да направим 3 екоката.
In 2017, we succeeded in getting a project to be funded by one of the packaging recovery organizations in Hungary, that is Ecopack. They funded us with 5,000 euro, which we used to construct 3 special points, green points, eco points, where people could put their separated waste.
И бяхме обявени за най-зелена община на 2017 година.
So we were also given the prize of being the greenest municipality of 2017.
Това са зелените екокътове. Пред многофамилните жилищни сгради успяхме да изградим тези екокътове, да сложим съдове за разделно събиране на отпадъка, както и за битовия отпадък, с единствената цел всяка жилищна такава сграда многофамилна, да се знае мястото и да се познава къде се изхвърля отпадъците.
So on these photos you can see how these eco-green dots look. They are servicing only multi-family residential buildings, so high-rise buildings, and the access is controlled by CHIP. So this was our purpose to get people used to the idea that this is where they should put their waste. So there are bins for separate recyclables and for the mixed waste there.
Освен това, се стремим във всяка една група от населението, то всяка една група от населението да достигне нашата кауза за разделно събиране на отпадъци.
So our aim is also to reach every section of society and teach them how to deal with the waste.
Това са част от проектите, които се реализират в детските градини и училищата.
These photos you can see some of the projects that we do in schools and kindergartens.
Където приучаваме най-младото население как да се справя с разделно събиране на отпадъци и изобщо какво означава разделно събиране на отпадъци.
Where we teach the younger generation on how to reduce and how to deal with waste.
Освен тези проекти, община Свиленград, изпълнявайки разпоредбите на Закона за управление на отпадъци, има изградени площадки за събиране на батерии, на лекарства, площадки за събиране на стари дрехи, всичко, което може да се изведе от битовия отпадък, се събира на определени площадки и се използва и се изземва от оползотворяващи организации.
So apart from these projects, we also, in fulfillment of the national legislation on waste, we have established special points for returning of special kinds of waste. So one type that households produce is hazardous waste. So old medicines and this kind of stuff, they can be separately collected, as well as old clothes and shoes, batteries, and I think this is for all.
Това, което е изключително важно и което направихме от началото на тази година, за да улесним търговските обекти и всички магазини, общината организира изземване ежедневно на хартия и пластмаса и тази хартия и пластмаса се транспортира до екоцентър, който сме оформили. По този начин, улеснявайки търговците, смятаме, че постигаме един много добър резултат в количеството разделно събрани отпадъци.
One very important step that we took this year is we started a door-to-door daily collection of paper and plastics from shops and businesses in the town. And this has an enormous effect in terms of recovering more material that can be recycled.
През тази година община Свиленград имаше възможност да кандидатства по оперативна програма Околна среда за една така, да кажем, революционна практика. Разработихме проект, който ще ни помогне да определяме таксата за битови отпадъци на база количество.
So this year we took the opportunity to apply for European funding for a very important and revolutionary for Bulgaria practice to get as close as possible to a punctual fair waste charge for citizens based on the pay-as-you-throw principle.
В проекта предвиждаме да закупим тиглилки, които ще бъдат инсталирани на сметосъбиращите машини.
The project includes installing weighing mechanisms, tools in the collection trucks.
Самото претегляне ще бъде свързано с система, която веднага да отчита количеството отпадък, битов отпадък на всяко едно домакинство.
And this would be connected to a central computer network which records the data.
Ще бъде разработен софтуер, който ще обработва много бързо тази събрана информация.
This also includes a development of special software to analyze this information.
Също така ще бъдат инсталирани сензори на самите съдове за събиране на отпадъци, които ще определят обема на отпадъка.
Also, the bins will be equipped with the special sensors that indicate how full the bin is.
Информацията, която ще получаваме от софтуера, ще ни дава възможност да правим справки и анализи и да организираме по-добре самото сметосъбиране и да контролираме процеса на разделно събиране на отпадъци.
So the information that we would be able to collect through this pilot project would enable us to analyze and plan much better and optimize our waste services.
Този проект не е самоцел, а е всъщност продиктуван от дългогодишната ни практика, в която се убедихме, че ако ние притегнем отпадъка и гражданите и бизнеса плащат на количество отпадък, това ще бъде най-добрият стимул за разделно събиране на отпадък.
So the aim of this project is not just to realize a project for the sake of itself, but it's based on our long-term experience, which shows that if we would be able to measure the waste produced by citizens and businesses and charge them according to the amount, then this would stimulate them to reduce their waste and to solve the problem.
След като изпълним този проект, добрата практика, която се надяваме, че ще утвърдим, ще разпространим след другите общини в България.
Once this project is realized, we hope that the good practice that it will become, we will be able to spread it to other Bulgarian and the international Bulgarian municipalities and beyond Bulgaria.
Освен това, през последните две години успяхме да напълно да закрием депото за отпадъци и да бъде рекултивирано и залесено с зелена растителност.
In the past two years we managed to completely close down our old landfill and recover it.
Успяхме чрез европейски средства да изградим пречиствателна станция за отпадни води.
Also using European funds we were able to construct a wastewater treatment plant,
което е част от нашата борба за чисти води, чист въздух и чиста околна среда.
Which is of course part of our policies, our fight for clean air, clean water, clean.
В момента изграждаме компостираща инсталация, в която ще бъдат събирани около 3000 тона зелена маса и биоразградими отпадъци.
Right now we are constructing a central composting facility with a capacity of 3000 tons per year that would be treating a green garden waste and biodegradable waste.
Проектът също се финансира с европейски средства.
This is also a European funded project.
И се надяваме, че след като започне да оперира тази компостираща инсталация, ще намалим значително общия отпадък.
And our hope is that once the installation starts working, we will be able to reduce our overall waste that we send for treatments a lot.
Свиленград, това е мото на общината, чрез членуването се в мрежата за нулеви отпадъци, чрез всички мерки, които приемаме, допринасяме своя скромен принос в борбата за опазване на околната среда и за съществуване на човечеството.
So our slogan is as a municipality that through our efforts, including our membership in Zero Waste Europe and all the steps we're taking, we aim to give our modest contribution to preserving the resources of this world.
Това е кмета на община Свиленград, инженер Георги Манов.
This is Свиленград's mayor.
Който 16 години е кмет на общината.
He's been there for 16 years now.
И под неговото мъдро и дълновидно ръководство общината се стреми към тази обща кауза за намаляне на отпадъка, за разделно събиране на отпадъка и за опазване на околната среда.
Under his wise and expedient governorship, the municipality has been able to start reducing waste, manage waste better and generally improve the environment.
Това са малко снимки от Свиленград, с които искаме да привлечем вашия интерес и да ви поканим да ни гостувате.
These are just some photo impressions from Svilengrad by which we mean to show you how it looks and invite you warmly to come visit us.
Виждате библиотеката на Свиленград и едно от най-старите училища.
You're looking at the library of Svilengrad and one of the oldest school buildings.
Това е парка на Свиленград и паметника на загиналите през Първата световна война.
This one of these is the park in Свиленград and the other one is a monument to all those who lost their lives in First World War.
Това е стария мост на Свиленград, една емблема на града.
This is probably the most emblematic photo for Svilengrad, it's the old bridge.
Тъй като е изграден през 530 година.
Which was constructed
И е паметник под егидата на ЮНЕСКО.
So it's protected by UNESCO as Разлог Петич.
И едно страхотно място за Разлог Петич на гостите и жителите на света.
It's a terrific place for walking, leisure time, rest for the visitors and students.
Така изглежда моста вечерта. И в крайна сметка всичко, което сме направили и сме постигнали, трябва да го оставим на бъдещото поколение в един честен.
So after all, everything that we've done in this life, we should leave for the next generation in nice.
Благодаря за вниманието. Надявам се, че в свободен разговор, ако имаме въпроси, може да се.
Thank you for your attention. I am available if you'd like to talk just face to face and answer any questions.
Общо е около 6500 тона.
So total for city for the town is like 6500 tons divided by.
А на жител е 200 и
няколко.
Като нашия стремеж е да останат около 50 кг.
We aim for 50 of the city of waste.
I know, okay, but just to say, consumism, West, and Bulgaria and so on. We have 550 average production of global production of euro. They have 200 million. So this is the point.
I would like to congratulations for your efforts. Zero waste, the bastards, that is not an easy treatment. It was an amazing treatment, so thank you for your message and thank you for your effort. Thank you so much for your message.
My name is Wojciech Fajon and I'm Vice President of Suwałki City Council. Suwałki is the city which is located in such landscape, and because of living in the hills area and lakes area and nature, we really think very carefully and very often how not to waste it, how not to waste this landscape and nature. And that's why we are here, that's why we really want to focus on zero waste policies. We're really happy to listen about your smart practices. And I would like to show you some our examples. I will start with our waste treatment policies. I have here the support of our experts, which is Deputy Mayor Łukasz Kurzyna. Kamil Gromadzki is from Waste Management Municipal Office. And so if you have some more detailed questions, you can of course ask and we will give you the answer, but I will tell you the story more from citizens' perspective. It's 70,000 of citizens living in Suwałki, and all them have the obligation of recycling the waste in their houses, in our houses. It's like 10 years already that we have this door-to-door system of collecting recycled waste. We need to have this blue bag for paper and cardboard, yellow one for plastic, metal and multi-material packages, green for glass, and this year we need a fourth bin in our houses, which is for bio-waste. So when you can imagine our big blocks of flats, like in Bulgaria or in other Eastern European countries, it's like 30 meters of my little flat, and I need four bins already to collect the trash. But that's how it works, and of course mixed waste in the separate one. So it's a challenge, but in the scale of country we started to do it, and how it works you will see in the next slides. Because of course it works thanks to the money that people pay for it, and we tried to do such policies like you introduced in Italy and in Bulgaria. So we thought about this like paying per throw, yeah? That's correct. Pay as you throw, yeah. That's how it worked for many years in Poland. But the result was that okay, people were forced to sign the agreement individually with the firm that collected the trash. And they paid for the amount of trash they produced. But the result was that this trash started to be found in forests, in the empty fields, or were burned in the household installations, in the just burned, giving the toxic waste in the air. So Polish government said, sorry, we give up with this approach, and they introduced the obligation of communities to operate all the waste management system. So we as a city, we collect all the waste, and people are paying the same amount of money, doesn't matter how much trash they produce. That's the idea to limit this environmental effect, which was really not good. So 6 euros monthly per house, and 4.5 euros monthly per this flat in blocks. Yeah, so that's the amount of money somebody has to pay. If the trash is not segregated, this tax is growing. And it's not our last word, because this fees will grow. Of course, people are angry, because for them it's a tax. But this, in this, like talking to angry people sometimes can be more fruitful, because it's lots of questions. Why do I pay so much? Yeah, and then we can give the answer. We can show how little recycle level we gain in our community, and we can ask how we can improve it altogether. So this is the Waste Management Municipal Company with the chief sitting here, and so all the trash should go here in our city, and this is, I think, in many your communities it looks the same. So this waste delivery goes to the sorting line, then we recycle some materials, and some are collected as pre-RDF to recover as a fuel. Some goes to bioreactors and biostabilization to keep the compost, and the rest goes to landfill. That's more or less the recycled system in Suwałki, which is like this company serves for 130,000 citizens, so for bigger area, not only our city. Sorry, and the amount of waste per head per year is 360 kilos. So it was like 500 in Italy, 200 in Bulgaria, we are somewhere in the middle. So this is the total amount of tons of delivery in last year. It's 32,000 tons, and 83% of this was collected as mixed. Only 8.8 was collected as selected. So coming from this selective recovery from the citizens. There is also the shock, which is a place that all the citizens can bring some bigger objects or some waste that is this hazardous waste. But as you see, it's not so many tons. The biggest is collected is mixed. But what happens with this 8%, yeah, that we have selected? As you see, half of these are packages, including plastics. When we talk about plastics and zero waste policies, this is something that we need to consider. The glass is like 80%, and paper and large size weight is the rest. So this first step of trash in this installation is for sorting, and it's thanks to the installation of biomechanical communal waste processing we do. All this trash from the sorting line looks like this. We try to get the better recycle level, trying to recover as much trash as we can on the lines. So it's like a few steps of such segregation that goes in this company. And so the next step is of course recycling when we have all these fractions selected. In shop it's 17 fractions that we gather, 17 fractions, and this is one of them, PET, so it's plastic, that we can sell. Still, there is a market for it. Tetra Pak is also recycled by the companies that buy it from us. So we deliver it to recycle enterprises. And the next step is composting of bio-waste, which is a good material, as you know. And later we can use it either for some grass planting or for our landfill to as a important layer for the stability of the landfill. And what is the total recycle from waste? So when we have all the selected trash and all mixed processed by our company, we get 12 tons of recycled material, and half of it is so-called pre-RBF, which is high calorific material. And something that is a big challenge, not only for our commune, but for many others in Poland now, because we don't have so many installations to incinerate, so burn this fraction, and the Ministry of Environment now is limiting the new permissions to build new installations. We'll see how it how it will go in the future, because this amount of radioactive waste is growing all over the Poland, and we get many news now in the television and media about burning landfills, and of course it's not landfills, but it's radioactive that is burning by accident, because there's nothing to do with it. We can't put it in the landfill, and we don't have space to treat it as a fuel. We in our company will try still to deliver it to cement factories, because they have the installation to use it as a fuel. But we'll see how it goes. What about this compost that I was talking? We are closing now one of our landfills, and we will use it as this cover of the vegetation. This half meter that we need to close this landfill and to start to recover this area, recultivate it. So we use this compost ourselves. And what's the challenge of not only Kamil sitting here now, but he tries to cope with all this growing trashes, and these three younger guys you can meet tomorrow, because they came with us to exchange some practices with your teenagers. So I'm really happy of this contact, because they will need to cope with these plastic bags, with plastic cups from yogurt, fast food meals. That's something that plastic cups is the waste that is completely not recyclable now in Poland, for example. There's no client that would buy it or we can deliver it. Anybody. So the other challenge is something that I was talking before, that we need to build some modern local waste to heat installations, but we are waiting for some better atmosphere in government, because now saying about burning trash in Poland has a very bad impact, bad media, bad PR. And even if we talk about power line, Kirolizam. and other chemical processes that don't keep the emission of this toxic air fractions, it's still not popular to talk about it, but we need to start and have it. And from habits, we got long life education. And we'll be really happy to see your projects, how you convince your citizens to recycle in these door-to-door systems. Because only these actions, information projects, your ideas will lead to this wider environmental sensitivity and consciousness. So we brought just three zero-waste smart practices from Slovakia. I didn't bring the actions that we do in schools, in kindergarten, because I believe everybody does it. And I think we need to do it in a bigger scale, so like constantly. But I brought some ideas that are not so obvious. Two of them are made by enterprise, so by companies, and one is totally with CIVIC. Number one is production of hats. Hats are cycled from Utah bags and from workwear. This lady is the owner of the small factory. It's like 12 women sewing really individually every hat. It needs a lot of manufacture because every part of old jeans or old Utah bag is different, and we need to also put the process of design in sewing it. So such hats that are produced in Suwałki goes to rehats the belly, because there is marketing and there is the market. There are the clients that will buy such such hats for a little higher prices than in Poland. But they are, let's say, made in Suwałki. The second practice is the wooden eyeglasses, which is the approach of not producing waste in the already in the design level of your product. So when you get the standard sunglasses, you have the plastic eye frame and the glass, or piece of plastic when it's sunglasses. This guy invented something like wooden eye frames, which are environment friendly, because it will not be the harmful waste in next 100 years. And it's really unique and really fashionable. And he has he sells it in his own brand, Helios, but also selling like 90% of his production goes to Italy, to Germany, to Great Britain, to Canada, to USA, under other brands. So if you want to start a business here and selling Italian wooden wooden eyeglasses, just call me. He has it already in this shop. And the third is shopping bags. Shopping bags, which is literally the biggest problem now in Poland, because when you go to the supermarket, you have all your vegetables and fruits in these plastic bags. These wrapped plastic bags, which are free, so people use it for tons in this part of Poland. And Kamila and her friends started to sew reusable bags, and they do it from light curtains and from bedding. So these light curtains are quite transparent, they don't have they have 0 grams almost, and are very handy. So they have all the features that plastic bag has. From the bedding, she sewed such bags for bread. Yeah. So it really helps to reduce plastic bag waste in Suwałki landfill. If she managed to convince first 10 people they will use it, she already did it. But my friends, all they use it. If this 10 will convince another 100, this 100 will convince another 10,000. Maybe in this Suwałki scale we will manage to solve the problem of plastic bag waste. So these three ideas you will see, you will be able to touch it, to feel it tomorrow in the exhibition, because these three guys will show it to you. We have the hats, we have these bags, and we have sunglasses. Thank you very much.
our parliament is going to announce an emergency situation in waste management system in Riga, and it and it impacted here, yeah, okay, and it impacted also our presentation and our delegation, because my colleague Rudi Vester from Ministry of Environmental Protection and Regional Development, she is the main expert in Latvia, and she has to be in the parliament today, and that's why Minister didn't allow her to come here and to make a presentation. So I will try to manage with her presentation, but in the beginning I want to say that I and my colleagues, we represent the Latvian Association of Local Governments, and our association unites 118 municipalities from 119, so only one municipality is not a member. And I'm Secretary General Association, and I'm responsible for international cooperation, SDGs, and project management. So I'm not an expert in environmental issues, but I will do my best. And in Latvia, we have only 2 million people, and all Latvia regarding the waste management is divided into the 11 regions, and in our country we have 11 landfills, and only one has a waste landfill. Before, in 1998, we had more than more than 558 dumps, and now they all are closed, and almost all are remediated. So we have done a big job. And here you can see the responsibilities of the ministry and of local governments. And local governments are responsible for organization of municipal waste, and municipalities issue local regulations, ensures financing for the infrastructure, and also selects provider of waste services. And here are some pictures of from our fields and from our sorting places. And in Latvia, collection and transportation of municipal waste is carried out by municipal and private waste management companies. And the share is 50-50. And nowadays, we are preparing many acts, and we are discussing a lot about circular economy. And since 2008, we also have introduced higher tax rate for plastic bags attached by retailers to goods or products for customers' convenience or advertising design, regardless whether it's in charge or not. And from this year, we don't have any plastic bags in our shops free of charge. If a customer wants to have a plastic bag, he or she has to pay for it. One more initiative is also very important. The ministry developed the guidelines for municipalities for public procurement and management services, and we use approach of smart cities. And there are some activities from our entrepreneurs. For example, there is some kind of informative campaign, the No Straws, and also our young people who came here, they also use this metal straw and not the plastic. And in our main cafeterias, there is also some kind of activity that you come with your hat, and then you can get a 10% discount. And also a number of big festivals in our three different kinds of concert shows. There is a special deposit, feedback store, we call it, where you can get a glass, and afterwards you can give your money, you can get your money back. And so these are some activities which are provided by our entrepreneurs and about our society. And we also have many feedback stores where you can come with your jobs and your even kind of bags and buy a So thank you. Sorry for.
Not that actually
yes, did, exactly.
But it was very clear and very present for the effort that you spent in the action you made. I'm impressed by the relationship between people in yes. This good practice.
Especially young generations, they are very keen on the life style and they are doing different
types of activities. Okay, okay. Well, we could make good work. Okay, so every schedule is changed. So I go to Spain if it's possible to present.
Buenos días, good morning. Buongiorno. Mi nombre es Soledad, soy concejal de residuos y objetivos de desarrollo sostenible en el Ayuntamiento de El Boano, Cerceda Matalpino, de España.
Soledad es la. That is the responsible person for recycling of the Council of Boano Cerceda Matalpino, that is near Madrid.
It's my first time, my first presentation. El Boano Cerceda Matalpino is a little town with 7,500 habitantes.
It's a small town located in the northwest area of Madrid with 7,500 inhabitants.
Estamos integrados en el Parque Nacional de la Sierra de Guadarrama y somos reserva de la biosfera.
Part of Guadarrama and also part of the Spanish network of Biosfera Reservation.
¿Cómo empezó todo? En nuestro municipio la recogida de residuos se realizaba a través de una empresa privada.
How did everything start? At the beginning, there was a private enterprise in the municipality that did the collection of waste.
Todos nosotros, dentro del gobierno, nos preocupaba no solamente lo que el quitar los residuos de nuestras calles, ¿no? Sino qué se hacía después con estos residuos.
Everyone was worried at the beginning, not only about the waste, but where did this waste end before the waste?
Y sobre todo, cómo poder reducirlos.
And how how to reduce waste, of course.
En julio de 2016, el ayuntamiento asume directamente la gestión de todos estos, de todos los residuos del municipio. Y ahí pues comienza nuestro camino. Realmente estamos empezando.
So starting from July 2016, the municipality the municipality started to take the direct management of the waste collections and recycling.
Estos son un poco todos los proyectos que actualmente estamos desarrollando en el lugar.
These are all the projects and strategies that are improving in Gualo.
In point, en julio del 2017, reutiliza, reuse, cualquier vecino de la localidad puede llevar objetos a este punto del municipio, objetos que tengan un segundo uso.
They have a reuse point in the municipality, so every neighbor that wants to bring old items to be reused can do it. Old chairs, furniture, baby items, books, prams for children.
En los avicomposteros están situados junto a las escuelas.
And near schools, we have these hands composting. They used to compost food residues used with hands.
Todos los residuos orgánicos que se generan en el comedor escolar se los comen las gallinas y otra parte se composta.
All the organic waste that comes from school canteens, for example, is used as food for hens, and everything that is residual is used as a composting.
Las gallinas se encuentran al lado de las escuelas. Estos espacios están gestionados por familias del colegio que todos los días limpian los gallineros y como recompensa se llevan los huevos a su casa.
The point is managed by families of the school that every day they clean the hen house, and they take home. They can take home eggs.
Compostaje, tanto domiciliario como compostaje comunitario.
Composting is made in houses, but at the same time municipality.
Comenzamos el proyecto con 100 familias y actualmente hay más de 250 familias.
We started with 100 families and homes, and now we have more than 250 houses.
Existen 13 compostadores, 13 espacios de compostadoras comunitarias.
They have installed 13 community composting machines.
Y es todo de manera, los vecinos y vecinas de nuestro municipio, de nuestro pueblo, lo hacen de manera totalmente gratuita. Nosotros les facilitamos todo el material.
The municipality helps with materials, but the composting is done on a volunteer and a free base. Everyone do it for free.
El sistema de puerta a puerta, door to door.
They use a door to door system for collecting waste.
Lamentablemente, los residuos municipales no paran de crecer. Y principalmente por todos los envases y los embalajes de un solo uso.
Waste collection, they use the system with the boards, posts, and hooks. You put the bag on the hook, and they collect the waste. Unfortunately, the amount of waste is still growing, basically because of the packaging, single-use packaging, and embases.
Todo el material también se ofrece a los vecinos de manera gratuita. Las bolsas y los cubos.
Bags and bins. So bags and bins are all free for people, provided by the consumer.
This is the objectives. The desperation.
The main goals are to better separate waste at origin. Awareness tool is how to educate people. And the separation of compostable organic matter. The goal to reduce the volume and the amount of mixed waste and to reduce the cost.
Tengo que deciros que nuestro pueblo es el único municipio de la Comunidad de Madrid que realiza puerta a puerta.
The only municipality in the community of Madrid to realize the
de Madrid, Comunidad de Madrid, tiene 180 pueblos.
120 municipalities in the community of Madrid, they are the only ones to have the door to door.
Esto se recogía puerta a puerta de residuos vegetales.
It's the door to door pickup collection of vegetal residual waste in green bags.
Sí. Porque donde vivimos es una zona de muchas casas tipo villa.
There municipality there are many detached houses, like cottages, with gardens. That's why they have a lot of organic waste.
Esta saca tiene un coste de 4 euros por euro.
It costs 4 euros.
Y te lo recogen en la puerta de tu domicilio, de tu casa. Estas son las islas verdes que usamos cuando tenemos un evento en el municipio para separar todas las fracciones.
And every time they have a feast, a fair, an event, a public event, they build a small green island to separate all the waste.
Este verano, por primera vez, hemos facilitado de manera gratuita también unos vasos reutilizables para las fiestas locales.
As you can see, this time for the first time this summer, they try to eliminate the high percentage of single-use glasses
using, for example, single-use crockery or reusable glasses.
Y este es nuestro rebaño de cabras municipal.
This is the herd of goats in the municipality. They live in a separate protected area.
Los objetivos principales que queremos conseguir con este proyecto es recuperar una raza de cabra que está en peligro de extinción.
They are trying to save this particular breed goats that is going to extinct.
Autóctona de la zona.
Is local breed.
Cabra guadarrameña. Estas cabras colaboran con la eliminación de matorral, colaboran como cabras bombero.
They cooperate as a fireman goat to protect the environment.
Como vivimos en una zona de campo y monte, pues limpian el monte.
They keep all the fields and the mountains clean, eating the grass, so they cooperate with the safety. Yeah.
Además de fertilizar el suelo y ayudar a regenerarlo.
And they help to fertilize and regenerate how many goats?
Los residuos vegetales que habéis visto antes de la saca verde,
the organic waste in the green bag, we have seen before,
se los llevamos a las cabras.
Is used for the goats.
Se comen lo verde, las hojas.
They eat the leaves. They eat the green leaves.
Y las ramas se trituran para compostar.
And branches are ground to realize
Tenemos también en nuestro municipio, en nuestro pueblo, una fábrica de cerveza artesanal. Y los residuos de la cebada que ellos utilizan para hacer su cerveza también se llevan al rebaño de cabras para que ellas se lo coman.
They have the municipality a craft beer brewery and the residual waste of the process seeds that are used in the process, all the residual waste is used to make compost and to feed the goats.
También este rebaño genera empleo verde, puesto que hay una persona que es responsable del cuidado de los animales.
At the same time, the goats generate green jobs. Need of a person that takes care of the goats.
También colaboramos con una escuela agraria de la ciudad de Madrid.
They also cooperate with a farming school in the city of Madrid.
Y al comienzo del proyecto se elaboraba quesos artesanos.
At the beginning of the project, they used to produce artisanal cheese.
Sí, también utilizamos el proyecto para ocio familiar. Tenemos actividades de pastoreo en familia por el monte con nuestro rebaño de cabras.
at the same time they cooperate with families because they are amused and they have fun taking the goats in the fields. They help in killing the goats.
Este es Isidro, nuestro macho. Tras la barrera y los quesos.
That's the evolution of the management
waste. Esta es la situación que nos encontramos antes de comenzar todos estos proyectos.
That's the initial situation the project started in 2016. Sí, just 3 years ago.
Como podéis ver, es horrible. El inicio de estos proyectos, al poquito de empezar a realizarlos, pasamos a tener estos porcentajes, de un 95% a un 78%.
Since the beginning they tried to separate waste, so at the beginning there was the major part was the mixed waste. Now they can sort different kind of waste. That is mixed waste, the gray one. Then the yellow one is plastic. The blue one paper. The green one glass. And also some the others are the big objects that can be reused or recycled. And the orange one is the clean point.
Actualmente es un poco mejor que estos datos que son del año pasado.
They are improving. These numbers refer to the last year.
Y estas son las fotos que normalmente usamos para concienciar a la población sobre la necesidad de realizar una buena gestión de residuos.
And these photos are usually they use this photo to raise awareness in the conscience of the common people.
Estos son los datos que tenemos también de finales del año pasado sobre la recogida puerta a puerta. Como podéis ver, cambian totalmente.
And these numbers are referring to the door-to-door collection of the last year, at the end of the last year, so they have changed a lot since the beginning of the project. For example, 43% organic. And 25% paper and mixed waste, 10% since the first one was 98%. At the beginning it was almost all mixed waste.
Por desgracia, hay muchas personas en España que les queda mucha conciencia medioambiental.
And unfortunately, in Spain, many people don't have environmental awareness.
Es muy importante también la concienciación medioambiental, como comentaban antes, en los colegios.
So it's very important to have awareness in schools too, so they have projects about the school education.
Los proyectos que estamos realizando actualmente en relacionados con la gestión de residuos ha supuesto un antes y un después para el desarrollo de los centros educativos del municipio, de los colegios del municipio. Y cada vez también los colegios han querido sumar a todas estas cuestiones ecológicas. Concienciación sobre el cambio climático.
The education projects in schools are about awareness about climate change. Activities connected with the environment.
Proyectos para el aprendizaje en las aulas.
Projects about learning in the schools.
Separación de los residuos en las clases.
Sorting of waste in the school rooms.
Eliminación de los plásticos de un solo uso.
They try to eliminate single-use plastic. For example, children used to carry their reusable cup.
Actualmente, uno de los colegios del municipio pertenece a la Red de Escuelas Sostenibles de Madrid.
Currently, one of the schools belongs to the Sustainable School Network of Madrid.
Y también realizamos actividades encaminadas a la eliminación de emisiones de CO2 en la atmósfera, como son el bicibus y el pedibus.
They use to they promote activities for the removing of CO2 in the atmosphere. For example, beach bus and the pedi bus. So children go to school by bike or walking all together.
Estos son los alumnos de secundaria en una clase de física y química, conociendo cómo se realiza el proceso de compostaje, por ejemplo.
These are the students of the secondary school in a lesson of chemistry and physics. They are learning how to realize compost.
En marzo del 2017, Zero Waste Europe nos reconoce como el primer municipio residuo cero en Madrid.
As you see, Boado was the first municipality residuo cero en Madrid. Zero residuo. Zero waste.
Y estos son recortes de prensa de longitud de reportajes que nos han realizado.
And these are all press articles realized about Boado.
Es un reportaje muy bonito que nos hicieron en Escarabajo Verde, que se titula La aldea Gala, como Asterix y Obelix.
Es un photographic reportage about the green beetle.
It's a television program.
Ah, it's a television program called the Scarabajo Verde, the green beetle, about Boado, and the title, La Aldea Gala, is taken from the Asterix and the Obelix comics.
A ser el único municipio de todo Madrid. Este es el comisario europeo, con mi antigua compañera de medio ambiente, que actualmente ya no está con nosotros.
Es el EU commissioner, European commissioner, together with a colleague of Soledad.
Y esto es uno de los premios más reconocidos que hemos tenido hasta ahora, que es el premio CONAMA, que nos lo dieron el año pasado.
In 2019, they had the CONAMA Prize, which is happening.
Que lo recogimos de la mano de la ministra de Transición Ecológica de España, Teresa Rivera. Para nosotros pues ha sido un honor.
And the prize was given to their representatives by the Minister for Ecology of Spain herself.
Un premio a la
honor to receive this prize.
Premio a la sostenibilidad de municipios de 5.000 a 30.000 habitantes.
It's a prize for sustainability for municipalities from 5,000 to 30,000 people.
Or textile or some other craft in the area. However, during the last years, we combined modernity with different ways of spending people's life and people's time, like spas, for example, as you see here. So there are pictures of pensions and of hotels in the area, known in Saint-Rochelle, which are very important things for people which are trying to reduce plastic, to reduce carbon.
Okay,
another important project for important project for us is a 300 hectares project, which aims crops for blueberries, blackberries, and also an airfield and a holiday village. If you have a look over this project, that's one of the most important projects we have. And some pictures I want to show you and movie with the first aircraft that landed 2 years ago in Saint-Rochelle. It provides Saint-Rochelle with also a sky gate for people who come to our places and who, once they come as visitors, will become their our friends. That's one of our invitation for you to come here and to become our friends, to our region, to the mayor, congratulating the pilot here. And that's one of the most important things, that in our community we are, let's say, pilot community, pilot municipality. An important project that we have, and where environment is very, very important for us, is a holiday village. So we try to build in a very old village and to produce it right now, to start from the scratch, to create a lake there, and to have more villages for holidays, for people wishing to come and to spend their holidays into our area. Why I tell you about this project? Because all these projects are environmentally free projects. So we come here to learn, as I said at the very beginning. We really want to share your experiences. We want to learn from your experiences, and we come here to take your best practices and to bring them and to copy them into our place. These are some pictures with this project, the holiday village, which we're going to build, and just some drawings to see how it will look like. But however, the most important project that we want to tell you about, it will be in a couple of seconds from now, is a project launched by Saint-Rochelle Municipality, and it's our last project. It's a result of a meeting like the one we have today, based on Italian patent on exchange we had with Italy. What is this project about? This is about, as I told you, Italian patent waste management. It's a project that tries to bring energy and to use biomass for our public buildings, schools, kindergartens, and municipalities. Here we had some pictures with people coming to collect our waste. And our main goal is to see, learn, and apply Google practices, as I said at the very beginning. And that's why we came here, to learn from you. That's our main goal here. To learn from people like you, from municipalities like you, from all of you. Either in the class here or during the breaks, during the meetings we will have, during the workshops, or that's very important, during our face-to-face meetings and during our exchanges which are going to be in the upcoming days. I'd like to thank you very much for having invited us here, because we are convinced that less waste is a better life, and a better life and the standard for more happiness. And that's what we plan to have, less waste and a better life and a higher standard, in fact, for our whole lives. Thank you very much. I just wanted to be very, very sure that I launched my invitation to come to us, to come to our places, and to try to share with us what you have learned, what you have applied, and what we can learn from you. Thank you very much.
You said you are last in this field, but you are very fast to get messages and photos. And you put us well.
So that's my computer back from the hotel. You know something from my home, so.
Okay.
Ringrazio per la sua esperienza, veramente per noi
ringrazio.
È stato molto importante, e sono stato molto per aprire
ringrazio.
Okay. If you have any questions
or we have time, please ask questions.